If you want to get the most out of Trello, you need to be using Powerups. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you five of my favorites. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, and I'm excited to be back on the Keep Productive channel. You know, there's an awful lot of power-ups to choose from when it comes to using Trello. So today, I'm going to introduce you to five that I think you're going to love. So the very first power-up on my list is custom fields. And I recommend that everyone turns on custom fields when they first start out with a new Trello board. Why? Well, it doesn't matter if you are creating a board just for yourself or if you're collaborating with others, most likely you're going to need some custom fields, whether that's text, numbers, or even a particular drop-down menu. So let's take a look at how custom fields look on a particular board. In this board that you see here, you will notice that I have some additional information on the front of my cards. I've got a satisfied checkbox, I've got a start date, I even have a color-coded priority here. So if I click on this card, you will notice that I'm actually using four different custom fields. I've got a text field here, which I'm using as a name. I've got a priority menu here, which I can change. I'm going to change that to low right now. I've got a checkbox, and I've got a start date. All you need to do is enable the custom fields power-up and select the custom fields button, and you can add up to 50 different custom fields per board. That's right, custom fields per board. So I don't think you're going to run out anytime soon. Of course, you can reorganize the way that they are displayed within your card. And even more importantly, you can decide if you want them to be shown on the front of the card or not. Remember how I had this checkbox on the front of my card? I'm going to uncheck this here. And now I won't see that information on the front of my card. Maybe just the start date and the priority level is what's most important to me. So you can add whatever you want with custom fields. So be sure to check out the custom fields power-up. Now the next power-up on my list is all about bringing a card back at a better time. You may be familiar with a snooze feature within your email or perhaps your task management client. Well, did you know that there's a power-up called Card Snooze, which allows you to do the exact same thing? So let's go back to our Trello board here, and let's say that I don't want to see this card right now. I know I need to get it done, but I don't want to see it in this list or on this board until tomorrow. Well, all I need to do is open up the card, and under the power-up sections, here you see I have a snooze button. By selecting the snooze button, I have two choices. I can either choose a specific time by selecting choose time, or I have all of these defaults to choose from. And I really love these defaults, everything from 1 hour all the way to 1 month. So I'm going to snooze this until tomorrow morning. I'm going to select that option, and what you will notice is what happens is that it actually archives the card. It tells us right at the top, this card is archived. So if I need to go back and find it, if I need to go back and unarchive it or find some information, I can easily do so. But the great thing is that it has been removed from this list and it will automatically reappear at that designated time, whatever you choose with that snooze button. Now, the next power-up on my list is fantastic if you are wanting feedback, either from other people that you're collaborating with on the same board, or if you have a public board and you want to allow other people to vote on particular cards. It's called the voting power-up. And of course, depending on the type of board that you have, you can choose who can vote on those particular cards. In my particular example, I've just got a private board here, so I'm only going to allow members in this case. So how does the voting power-up work? Well, if I open up any one of my cards, you will notice under the actions section, I now have a new button and it's called vote. So let's say I want us to tackle this particular project. So I'm going to give it an upvote. And you can see right near the top, right beside the labels, you can see those votes. In fact, if I click on it, I can see that I'm the one who voted for that particular task. And so as I have other people who vote, I can also see their results as well. Now, I can simply click this button again if I want to remove my vote. And of course, I can't rig the system. I can't just keep hitting this to give myself more votes. But let's upvote this one more time, and I'm going to close it. And you will see that you can actually see the voting icon on the front of the card as well. So it can be really easy for you to see which cards have received more votes than others. But it gets even better. If I go to the top of this list, or any list that has cards that have been voted, I can select the sort by option, and I can sort by the most number of votes. So I'm gonna select that option, and automatically that card, because it's the only one with a vote in this case, is gonna shoot right to the top. So be sure to check out the voting power-up, especially if you're wanting feedback from your team or whoever has access to your board. Now, the next power-up in this list may just be one of the most powerful power-ups in all of Trello, and that is Butler. Why is it called Butler? Well, Butler allows you to automate almost anything within your Trello boards. Now, it would be next to impossible for me to give you a full review or a full taste of what Butler can do, but let me show you at least two examples. So if I select the Butler link in the top right-hand corner, you can see that you can create custom buttons that perform certain actions. In this case, I've created a button that's called Take Task, and all I've done is that I have set certain components to tell it what to do. So for example, this is what's going to happen when I select the Take Task button in any one of my cards. I'm going to join the card. I'm going to post a comment that says task started. It's going to set a due date in 1 week's time and move the card to the top of the list of this one here, to do this week. Now, if you want to see how this all happens, I'm going to click the edit button just to show you how easy it is for you to create the actions within a Butler card or a Butler button. So here we go. Here are the four different steps that are going to happen. So let me close out of it, and I'm going to open up one of these tasks here on the left-hand side. So this sample task is just a brand new task, and let's say that I want to take it. So here is my Butler button, take task. I'm going to select it. I'm going to select it once, and let's see what happens. Ooh, a few things have changed on here. Look at this. So, for example, it's added a due date 1 week from today. It's added me as a member of this card. It has also, here we go. Here is the comment that was just added. Task started, and did it move it? Let's close it and make sure. It did move it. It moved it to this list. So four different things occurred, and I could have added even more simply by selecting that one single button. That's pretty amazing, isn't it? Now let's go back to the Butler interface, and this time I want to show you a rule. So this is a little bit different, but it's set up very similar to as we saw with the custom button. So in this case, here's what's going to happen. When a card is added to the list pending, add the follow-up checklist to the card and set the due date in 48 hours. So in this case, we're actually going to add a custom checklist to this card simply by adding or moving a card to this particular list. So let's test it out. Let's see if this works. Here's my pending list over here. Why don't I take this card over here? It's pretty blank. It looks pretty blank to me. No one's assigned to it. There is no checklist in here. I just want to make sure that this isn't magic. There's no funny business here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this card and I'm going to drag it over into the pending list. Now, let's see. Whoa, look at that. Look at that. We've got the new due date within 48 hours of today, and we've got a checklist. Let's open up that card. Look at that. There's that follow-up checklist that we saw in the Butler interface. So yes, Butler is going to make your life so much easier, and you can customize it in almost any way that you like. So be sure to check out the Butler power-up. Now, to finish up our list of Trello power-ups, I want to include something specifically for those who may be using the Agile method of managing your projects, especially if you're involved in software development. Agile Tools is an excellent power-up if you are using your Trello boards for this type of work. So you will see on this particular board, I have a number of other pieces of information on the front of my cards. With the Agile methodology, you will often be using story points as a way to estimate how long a particular task or a particular piece of development is going to take. So by selecting the story points button, I can select one of these defaults here, or I can enter in a number on my own. And of course, I can customize these default buttons if I want as well. Not only do I see the story points here within the card, but of course I see it on the front of the card as well. If I select the Agile Tools link in the top right-hand corner, I can see a breakdown of all of those story points by list. So for example, I have the most number of story points, in this case 30 points, in the doing list, and I can also see the total down below. It also allows you to identify which cards on this board have not been estimated. So if I toggle this link, you will now see I have this red unestimated label on a large number of cards at this point. This allows me to quickly identify which cards have not been estimated. And I can toggle this on and off as desired. But there's another function that you may want to benefit from when using Agile tools, and that is this number here, the work in progress number. So, for example, you can set the limit of the number of cards allowed per phase, or in this case, per list. So what this is telling me is that I'm over. I'm 6 out of 5. I only want to allow 5 in this particular list. So I need to move on. I need to push something into another phase, or maybe archive it or push it back, depending on where it is. Here we see we have a 3 out of 5 telling me that we're okay. 5 is also the maximum in this list. But if I add too many, let's say if I take some of these out of here, now we are okay. We're yellow, 5 out of 5, 4 out of 5. That's good. But if I push one more over, what's going to happen? Yeah, it's going to let me know that we're over our maximum and we're going to need to push something out or make a hard decision. So you may be interested in finding out more and trying out Agile tools for yourself. So I hope you enjoy exploring these Trello power-ups and many more. Be sure to subscribe right here to the Keep Productive channel, and I hope you join me at the Simpletivity channel as well. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.